Hello children, in the previous session you started with parts of speech. You would have studied about noun and its types, and in today's session we will study about pronoun and adjectives and also its types in more detail. Pronoun. And now let us see the definition for pronoun. You would be already aware of what is meant by pronoun. Yes, pronoun is a word which is used in the place of a noun, and it does the work of a noun. Okay, children. So, pronoun is a word which is used in the place of noun. Example. Now, let us see an example for pronoun. John is a little boy. John goes to school regularly. John works hard. John loves to play cricket. John obeys his parents and teachers. In this sentence, the noun, that is the subject of the sentence, is repeated in each and every sentence. Did you notice, children? Yes. The noun John is repeated in each and every sentence. And now, instead of repeating the noun in each and every sentence, we use the pronoun he. Since John is a boy, we use the pronoun he. And now let us rewrite the above sentences. John is a little boy. He goes to school regularly. He works hard. He loves to play cricket. And he obeys his parents and teachers. Here the subject, that is a noun, John, is replaced by the pronoun he from the second sentence. Now let us see the types of pronoun. There are 9 types of pronoun. They are personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, demonstrative pronouns, reflexive pronouns, emphasizing pronouns, indefinite pronouns, interrogative pronouns, distributive pronouns, and relative pronouns. Okay, children. There are 9 types of pronoun, and let us see in detail about each type of pronoun. Personal pronouns. Pronouns that indicate person, thing, animal, etc. are called personal pronouns. We already know that in English grammar, there are 3 types of person. They are first person, second person, and third person. Isn't it? Who is the first person? The speaker is said to be the first person. So the speaker or the group including the speaker is said to be the first person. They are I, we, me, us, my, our are said to be the first person pronoun. Second person, the listener. That is the person or a group to whom the speech is being addressed is said to be the second person. They are you, your, and yours are said to be the pronouns of the second person. Third person, everyone else except the speaker or the listener is said to be the third person. They are he, she, it, they, him, her, them are said to be the third person pronoun. And now let us see some example for personal pronouns. He is brushing his teeth. Here he is the third person pronoun. They are learning their lessons. Here they is the third person plural pronoun. I always help the poor. So I is the first person pronoun. Okay, children. Possessive pronoun. What is meant by possessive pronoun? Possessive pronoun shows that something belongs to someone. For example, this pen is hers. So what does this sentence represent? That This pen belongs to
her.
Okay, children. So, what are some of the possessive pronouns? The possessive pronouns are my, our, your, his, her, its, their, mine, ours, yours, his, hers, its, and theirs. For example, the house on the corner is theirs. This pen is hers. That hat is mine. So, in all these sentences shows that something belongs to someone. Okay, children?
Demonstrative pronouns. Pronouns that are used to show or to indicate some nouns are called demonstrative pronouns. This, that, those, these are demonstrative pronouns. Example, this is my book. Here, the pronoun this indicates that the book belongs to him, her, or mine. So therefore, the demonstrative pronouns are used to show or to indicate some noun. Consider another example. Those are latest mobile phones. So here the pronoun those indicates the mobile phones. This computer is old. So here the pronoun this indicates that the particular computer is old. Okay, children? Did you understand? Reflexive pronouns. The words myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves are called reflexive pronouns. And now let us see how these pronouns are helpful. These pronouns, that is the reflexive pronouns, refer back to the subject of the sentence. For example, Rita taught herself how to bake. So here the word herself refers back to the subject of the sentence. Is it clear, children? In the second sentence, Lena learned herself how to drive a car. Here also the word herself refers back to the subject of the sentence. So the reflexive pronouns are used to refer back to the subject of the sentence. These reflexive pronouns are either used just after the subject or in the mid of the sentence. Is it clear, children? Emphasizing pronouns. The words myself, yourself, himself, herself, itself, ourselves, yourselves, and themselves are said to be the emphasizing pronouns. And now let us see what is the difference between the reflexive and emphasizing pronouns. The reflexive pronouns are used just after the subject or in the mid of the sentence. And in a sentence, even if the emphasizing pronoun is removed, the sentence will still make a complete sense. For example, Raju wrote it himself. Here, the emphasizing pronoun, himself, even if it is removed from the sentence, it still gives a complete meaning. Raju wrote it. Second example, Priya made it herself. So in a sentence, even if an emphasizing pronoun is removed, the sentence will still make a complete sense. Indefinite pronouns. Pronouns that show an indefinite or an uncertain number of people, person, or thing, then it is said to be an indefinite pronoun.
For example, all, none, some, everyone, everybody. All these are said to be indefinite pronoun. Example, all were hungry. None is happy these days. Some were very much pleased. So all these, all, none, some are said to be the indefinite pronouns. Interrogative pronoun. The pronouns that are used to ask questions are interrogative pronouns. What, where, who, whom, whose, what, which, where, when, why, how, when are said to be the interrogative pronouns. Example, what is your name? Where is the book? So, all these words, that is what, where, when, why, whom, all these words which are used to ask questions are said to be the interrogative pronouns. Distributive pronouns. Pronouns that are used to show the distribution of a noun are called distributive pronouns. So the distributive pronouns such as each, either, and neither refer to the person or things at one time. Example, each of the girls was given a present. Second example, neither of the suggestions is suitable. So in these examples, the words each, neither are used to show the distribution of a noun. So they are called as the distributive pronouns. Relative pronoun. Pronouns that are used to join two sentences and tells the relation with the noun that comes before it is said to be the relative pronoun. For example, I know the girl who is a dancer. So here the word who is used to join two sentences and it tells the relation with the noun that comes before it. So the words like who, whom, whose, which, that are said to be relative pronoun. Look at the second example. I like the ice cream which has a strawberry flavor. So in the above two examples, who and which joins the two parts of the sentence and it tells the relationship with the noun before it. Got it, children? Exercises. First exercise, you have to identify the pronoun in the sentence and you have to mention what type of pronoun it is. And now look at the examples. She met me on the highways. So which is the pronoun here? Yes, it is she and me. What type of pronoun it is? It is personal pronoun. Okay, children. So you have to underline the pronoun and you have to mention what type of pronoun it is. In the second sentence, I forgot my purse in the hall. Which is the pronoun here? Yes, it is I and my. Again, it is a personal pronoun. Look at the third sentence. Who are you talking to over the phone? Here, which is the pronoun here? Yes, it is who. And also it is you. So what type of pronoun is who? So here the pronoun who asks is used to ask a question. So it is said it is interrogative pronoun. And the pronoun you is again a personal pronoun. Look at the fourth sentence. She lost the book which I gave her. Here, which is the pronoun? She, I, and her. So all these are
personal pronoun and which. Here which is used in the middle of the sentence and it is used to join two sentences. So it is relative pronoun. And look at the fifth sentence. Each and every aspect has been discussed. Here each, every is said to be the pronoun. And what type of pronoun is that? They are distributive pronoun. So we have already studied each, either, neither, every, all, or all these are said to be distributive pronoun. Okay, children, shall we move on to the next exercise? Exercise 2. Here you have to fill in the blanks with suitable pronoun. First sentence, my name is Samuel dash am a German. So which is the pronoun used here? Yes, it is I. So my name is Samuel, I am a German. Second sentence, my parents live in Berlin. We visit dash often. We visit them often. Third sentence, let dash help you carry these bags. So which is the pronoun used here? Yes, it is me. Let me help you carry these bags. Fourth sentence, dash bag is this. So since we it is in the question type format, we have to use interrogative pronouns. So the answer is, whose bag is this? Fifth sentence, can dash tell me where dash can find a good restaurant? The answer is, can you tell me where I can find a good restaurant? Sixth question, that pen is dash. That pen is mine. Okay, children, got it? And now let us move on to the next part of grammar, it is adjectives. The next topic we are going to see about is adjectives. You would have already been aware of what is meant by adjectives. Adjectives are used to describe the noun or a pronoun. Now let us see in more detail about adjectives. Adjective. An adjective describes or modifies noun and pronoun in a sentence. Adjectives normally indicates quality, size, shape, duration, feeling, content, and more about noun. Example, they live in a beautiful house. So which is the adjective here? Yes, it is beautiful, because it describes the noun house. Second example, Leah's hair is gorgeous. Here gorgeous is the adjective. And the third example, my cake should have 16 candles. Here 16 is the adjective. Fourth one, a mischievous cat. Which is the adjective? Mischievous, because it describes about the cat. Next, we will see about the kinds of adjectives. First one is descriptive adjective or adjective of quality. Second one is demonstrative adjective. Third one is possessive adjective. Fourth one is quantitative adjective or adjective of quantity. Fifth one is numeral adjective. Sixth one is interrogative adjective. Seventh one is distributive adjective. And eighth is proper adjective. Okay, children, is it clear? And now we will see about each type of adjective in detail. Descriptive adjective or adjective of quality.
This adjective describes the nature or characteristics of a person, animal, or thing. That is, if an adjective describes about the nature or character of a person or animal or a thing, then it is said to be descriptive adjective or adjective of quality. For example, she is a clever girl. So here the adjective is clever, and it describes the nature or character of a person. So it is said to be descriptive adjective. Second one is, I bought an expensive watch. Expensive is an descriptive adjective. And third one is, we ate some delicious food. Here delicious is descriptive adjective. Demonstrative adjectives. To demonstrate or point to a particular person, animal, or thing, we use the demonstrative adjectives. The demonstrative adjectives are this, that, these, those. In general, we use this, that, these, those in order to point to a particular person, animal, or thing. In case it is singular, we use this and that, and if it is in plural, we use these and those. Is it clear, children? For example, this is my book. Okay, this is my book. Here, this points out that the book is mine. So therefore, this is said to be demonstrative adjective. And second example is, those flowers are very beautiful. Those flowers are very beautiful. Here, those are said to be demonstrative adjective. Possessive adjective. We use possessive adjective to show something belongs to someone. The possessive adjectives are my, your, our, his, her, its, and their. Okay, children. And now let us see the examples for possessive adjective. This book is hers. Those books are ours. So in this sentences, hers and ours are said to be the possessive adjective, because it is used to indicate that the book belongs to someone. Fourth one is a quantitative adjective or adjective of quantity. From the word itself, you can understand what is meant by quantitative adjective. Yes, it is used to indicate the amount of a noun, but it does not indicate an exact number. Example, some, many, much, more, less, several, a few, a little, a lot of, enough, and so on. So, these adjectives are said to be quantitative adjective, because it indicates the amount of a noun, and at the same time it does not indicate an exact number. Example, many people attended the function. Here, many, it expresses the quantity of the noun, and it does not indicate the exact number. So it is said to be quantitative adjective. Second example, there are only a few tomato in the basket. Here, a few is said to be the quantitative adjective. Okay, children? Numeral adjectives. The numeral adjective gives the number of noun, and it also shows the place of a noun in a sequence. For example, there are 6 baskets in the room. Okay, there are 6 baskets in the room. Here, 6 represents the number of noun. Okay, children, so here 6 is said to be the numeral adjective. Second example, my brother has 8 pencils.
My brother has 8 pencils. Here 8 represents the number of noun, so therefore it is said to be numeral adjective. Next one, it is interrogative adjective. So from the word interrogative we can understand that these adjectives are used to ask a question about a noun. Some of the interrogative adjectives include what, which, whose and so on. Example, what is the color of your dress? And the second example is, whose book is this? So in these sentences, what and whose are said to be the interrogative adjective. Distributive adjective. The distributive adjectives are used to describe specific members out of a group. And these distributive adjectives are used to single out one or more individual items or people. That is, they are used to separate one or more individual items or people. Some of the distributive adjectives are each, every, either, neither, any, and so on. Example, each of the person in the group is responsible for the loss. And second example is, neither of your dress are attractive. In the above examples, each and neither are said to be the distributive adjective. Proper adjectives. Most of the adjectives are common adjectives. Proper adjectives describes people, places and things, but they are based on names like proper nouns. You would have already studied about what is meant by proper nouns, isn't it? And the proper adjectives are same as the proper nouns. Example, I like to eat Szechuan noodles. Here, Szechuan is said to be the proper adjective. Example, I like to wear linen sarees. Here, linen is said to be the proper adjective. Okay, children, we have studied about the 8 types of adjectives. And now let us move on to the exercise. Exercise 1, underline the adjectives in the sentence. First sentence, the girl has a sweet voice. Which is the adjective here? Yes, it is sweet. Second one, I like red roses. Here, red is the adjective. Third sentence, always drink fresh water. Which is the adjective here? Yes, it is fresh. Because it describes the noun water. Next one, that boy is naughty. Which is the word which describes the noun boy? It is naughty. Naughty is said to be adjective. Next one, it is Rita has bought some new dresses. Here, the adjective is some. The last example, I don't like these shirts. Here, these is said to be the adjective. So what type of adjective is these? Yes, it is demonstrative adjective because it points to a particular thing. Okay children, now let us move on to the next exercise. And in the next exercise you have to underline the adjective and you also have to find the type of adjective. First sentence, a kind boy helped me. Which is the adjective here? Kind. What type of adjective it is? It is descriptive adjective. And the second one is, Priya had enough food. Okay children, here the adjective is enough and it expresses the quantity. Okay, so therefore it is said to be the quantitative adjective. And third one, few people in the group had 6 fingers. Here Six is said to be the adjective and it is the numeral adjective. And another adjective in the same sentence is few. And here few is said to be the quantitative adjective. Fourth sentence, whose pencil is this? Here whose is said to be the interrogative adjective. Okay children, is it clear? The next topic we are going to study about is formation of adjectives. So in this topic we will see how to form an adjective from a noun or a verb. In order to form an adjective from a noun or a verb, we should add suitable suffix to it. We add the suffix ent, ant, ive, ful, al, able, ible, yic, ous to the verbs or noun in order to form an adjective. Suffix are group of letters which are added to the word to form an adjective. For example, to the word grace, we add the suffix ful to form an adjective graceful. Magic, we add the word al to form the adjective magical. And to the word enjoy, we add the suffix able to form the adjective enjoyable. To the word help, we add the suffix ful to form the adjective helpful. And to the word talk, we add the suffix TAVV to form the adjective talkative. Okay children, are you clear? So in order to form an adjective from a noun or verb, we add suitable suffix to it. Exercise. Add the correct suffix to these words to form an adjective. And for some words, you need to change the spellings. Example, depend. Depend plus ent gives dependent, which is an adjective. Nation plus al gives the adjective national. Obey. You have to change the spelling slightly so that you get the adjective obedient. Accident, accidental. Danger, dangerous. Is it clear, children? So, complete the given grammar worksheets and send it to your WhatsApp group. And next, we will have the reading practice.
Hello, children. How are you? Hope you are all fine. Okay children, in the previous class you would have started the parts of speech and you studied about noun and its types. In today's class we will study about pronoun and adjective. You will be aware of what is meant by pronoun and adjective, isn't it? What is a pronoun? The word which is used instead of a noun is called as pronoun. So what are some of the pronoun? He, she, it, they, those, these, all these are pronouns. In this class, we will study in more detail about pronoun and its types. And next, we will study about adjective. What is an adjective? The word which is used to describe a noun is called as an adjective. For example, I saw a beautiful girl. So which is the noun here? Girl. And what word, which word describes the noun girl? It is beautiful. So here in this sentence, beautiful is the adjective. In today's class, we shall study in more detail about pronoun and also adjective and its types. And finally, we will have a reading practice. Okay children, shall we start? Hello children, in this session we will have reading practice. Okay, first I will read out this passage for you and then we will underline some of the difficult words in this passage and we will find the meaning of those words. And we will also see how to pronounce those words. Okay, children, are you ready?
Yes.
First, I will read out this passage for you. Listen carefully. Good for evil. In the previous session itself, you would have started reading practice on this lesson. And this is the continuation of that. And it is in page number 5. Okay, children, shall we start? Good for evil. Please give me a glass of water at least, said the Indian. I am really thirsty. Be off. You idle beggar, shouted the farmer angrily. The poor Indian turned and walked slowly down the road. I am tired of these beggars. They never let one rest in peace, he muttered when the Indian was gone. Okay, children, once again I repeat, please listen. Good for evil. Please give me a glass of water at least, said the Indian. I am really thirsty. Be off, you idle beggar, shouted the farmer angrily. The poor Indian turned and walked slowly down the road. I am tired of these beggars. They never let one rest in peace, he muttered when the Indian was gone. Okay, children, and now we will see the explanation for this passage. In the previous session, some people studied that there was a rich American farmer and he had many farms. One day he was standing in front of his farmhouse. At that time, a poor beggar, Indian beggar, passed by. And on seeing the rich American farmer, he requested him to give some food. But the American farmer denied. And later on, the Indian pleaded the American farmer to give him at least a glass of water. But the American shouted angrily and asked the farmer to leave the place. The poor Indian was really worried and he left the place. And once the Indian left the place, the American farmer said that these beggars are keep on disturbing him. And this is the explanation of this passage, children. And let us see the explanation more clearly. The poor Indian, who was hungry, asked the American farmer a glass of water. The Indian said that he was thirsty. The American shouted angrily at the farmer. The poor Indian was really worried and he turned and walked slowly. And he walked slowly down the road. The American murmured that he was tired of these beggars because they always keep disturbing him. Okay, children, and now let us underline some of the difficult words and then we will see how to pronounce those words and we will also find the meaning of those words. Okay, children, and now we will underline some of the hard words and we will find the meaning of the hard words from the passage. Okay, so the first one is be off. Be off means go away. And now let us look into this passage. Where is this be off? Be off. Be off, you idle beggar, shouted the farmer angrily. And so here be off means go away. Go away, you idle beggar, shouted the farmer angrily. And the second word is idle. Idle means lazy. What is meant by lazy? Lazy means sitting simply without doing any work. And those people are called as lazy, isn't it? So idle means lazy. And the third one is mutter. Mutter means murmur. What is meant by murmuring? Murmuring means speaking to oneself in a low voice. Okay. So in Tamil, that is murmur. So mutter means murmur. Okay, children, Theophanes, go away. Idle, lazy, muttered, murmured. And next we are looking at the home assignment. It is time for your home assignment. Complete the given worksheet. So already we have seen the parts of speech. In today's class we studied about pronoun and adjective. So the grammar worksheets are given to you in pronoun and adjective topics. Okay. So complete those grammar worksheets and you also practice reading this passage which is in page number 5 in your textbook. Okay. Practice this passage and also send the video recording of your reading practice to your WhatsApp group. Okay, children? Okay. Thank you.